What's going on, everybody? So today's video, got the wife here, and we're actually going to be doing a review from a brand that's I kind of introduced this brand to her, so she kind of likes the clothing. And you're a fan of Vince Camuto, are you not?
I am, yes.
So we're actually going to be doing a decant review, thanks to Stephen from the channel Red Lessons, and today we're going to be doing Vince Camuto Teta Extreme. So this scent was actually launched this year in 2020, and it's considered an Oriental Vanilla. The dry down's been here for the last, what time is it?
It is now 2:39.
For the last 25 minutes, I don't have my watch, so we gotta use her Fitbit. And I just sprayed this no more than a minute ago.
Okay.
The note breakdown, according to Fragrantica, top notes is gonna be grapefruit, bergamot, mandarin, and cinnamon, with the mid being rum, geranium, and orange blossom. And the base is tonka bean, ambroxan, and sandalwood, vanilla, and benzoin. Hun, is there a big difference from the first spray, which is gonna be on the back of the wrist or back of the palm, to that there? Is there a big difference?
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you get in that opening then?
The opening's actually a lot lighter than the dry down.
Ooh, okay. All right. I think so.
I get the orange blossom and vanilla.
Okay, so that's the, all right, so you're getting those mid notes in the
opening. Yeah.
Okay.
There's something very soft about it. For a minute, I thought there was lavender, but you didn't say lavender.
No, I did not.
I get a little bit of the mandarin. Yeah, but that's pretty much it.
And what about the dry down there? Old man stretch.
Whatever, some sandalwood. I get some sandalwood.
Okay.
I get something really heavy and I don't know what it
is. Maybe it's the rum. Maybe.
Yeah, but I know what that smells like. I don't think that's it.
Okay.
Maybe there's a mixture of that and something else.
Maybe
but
it's two notes in one.
Yeah.
So what I get is that in the opening, I definitely get the cinnamon or like a spice. So cardamom and the citruses along with that rum and that tonka bean. So I pretty much get those four notes right from the get-go. And the tonka bean and the rum are very prominent, along with that vanilla. I get like a slight ambroxan, not a whole lot, but I get more vanilla than ambroxan itself. This has a sweet, boozy feel to it. And even though that this is supposed to be a flanker to Vince Camuto Teta, I find that this kind of smells between Teta and Vince Camuto's Solare. I think it's because of that spicy accord. It's a fun scent. Does it have a youthful vibe to you, or do you find that this is more of for an older man?
I feel like the opening has a youthful vibe.
Okay.
The dry down, definitely old man.
Oh, okay. So when you mean old man, define that. Do you like 30-year-old, 40, 50?
I probably shouldn't use the words old man.
You call me old man.
Yes, but you're my old man.
That's true.
I guess maybe 40, 50s and above.
Okay, so you think that this is a fragrance for the more mature men?
Yes.
So something that's not really for me, because I'm not exactly the most mature guy.
Oh my god. Here we go.
But I do find that this does have that playful vibe. And I think that a younger guy could pull this one off along with an older man as well. So I find it's not exactly like, it's ageless, shall I say. But it's more of a college student type of age, not really a high schooler. So when would you see this being worn though? Like occasion wise?
That's hard to say. I think maybe evenings. Okay. I think I wouldn't recommend it for everyday use. I would recommend it for everything other than, you know, like your daily casual type of fragrance.
Oh, just daily casual?
No, anything other than the
daily
casual.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
All right, so like, well, for me, this is a bit of a going out scent. It has a bit of a suit and tie type of feel as well.
Yeah.
Does it have a more nighttime vibe or a daytime vibe?
More of a nighttime vibe.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so maybe because of the name Extreme, who really knows? I find that this is a scent for a gentleman who has that mature side, but knows when to kind of like let loose and let that youthful spirit come out a little bit.
That's an interesting way of putting it.
Seasons,
like it.
When would you say?
Definitely winter.
Okay, so fall and winter for me. Mm-hmm. And longevity off this thing was actually 7 to 8 hours, and projection was more so on the moderate side. So you're definitely going to get a full day's worth out of this if you mm-hmm. wear it to work. I think you can wear it to work, just you got to be mindful of your applications. Price tag for this. This one is a little bit harder for us up here in Canada to get. And it's not exactly sold on the discounters just yet, but in due time, mm-hmm. all Vince Camuto's will. But I've seen these on, I think it wasn't Macy's, and I know that Stephen got his from Macy's. I forget where I saw it, but it was $90 USD. So when you convert that, that's about $110, $115 Canadian. So that's kind of like the standard norm mm-hmm. when it comes to fragrances at the HBC, which this is not sold. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's just make this video a little bit shorter. Any final thoughts that you could offer?
I like the opening a lot more.
Okay. Well, this is more the dry down now, but I know what you mean.
Yeah, I find it to be less cloying, more fresh. And
the citruses.
Yeah. While I do like the dry down, I think it's just for a different time, different occasion. Like you said, I think you worded it beautifully. I think it's for more suit and tie.
Okay, yeah. All right. I remember Red Alessin saying that this is more for a younger man. Mm-hmm. I find it is ageless. It smells good. I like it. I like the brand overall. Mm-hmm. Vince Camuto does get flack a lot from a lot of guys in the community. I just think it's an overall great scent. It's not wonderful. It's nothing new, groundbreaking, mm-hmm. but it smells mass appealing. And this, I find that this is more so for a guy who just wants a few fragrances in his collection. I do think that it is actually quite versatile, dressing mm-hmm. it down to dressing it up. It has that mature component, mm-hmm. but with like a youthful twist to it as well.
There,
so longevity is very good. I find it does have some sex appeal. I personally does. Do you think it does?
I think it definitely does, yes.
It is masculine. And if you were to give this a rating out of 5, what would you give it, hon?
I would give it a 3.5 out of 5.
And I would give it a 4. So I think it's a great, solid release. I don't know if I would say it's one of the better ones. Mm-hmm. Top 5, no. Top 10, yes.
Okay.
So guys, that is our take of Vince Camuto's Teta Extreme. Steven, Red Lessons, thank you very much for the sample. I really do appreciate it. And we're actually going to finish off this very video now so we could actually do another video that was possible because of Red Lessons. That one will probably go out before this very one. But guys, if you like this very video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Share the video, subscribe if you're new to this channel. If you want to see other videos that the wife and I have done, check these two columns out right here that are blocking our beautiful faces.
Oh my God.
So guys, we thank you for time. Take care, and we will see you later. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Bye.